Life of Black Tiger, My Name is Mayo, Horse Racing 2016, Radiation Island, Gasp, Flat Out 3. Have you ever heard of any of these games? Chances are if you have, it's mostly because you've heard about how terrible it is and how you should probably avoid it at all costs. So, my question for the community is this. Do we need a gaming approval process? Now, to be clear, I do not mean to confuse this with certification. In order to put your game on any storefront, you have to first get it certified to make sure that it works and plays properly on the system you are submitting for. Instead, what I'm asking is, should there be an approval process to have the game available for purchase in the first place? Think more of a do we even want or need this game on the store type of approval. There are just so many games available today, and when you look at the trailers for some of these, it just looks like there was zero effort put into the game, and there's honestly no reason to play it. Look at Life of Black Tiger, I mean, it's a complete joke. It's something no one should spend their time or money on. And it makes me think, why is it even on the store to begin with? Obviously, this is a very subjective situation, and one that can go downhill really quickly. Say this does become a thing, and there are teams now that approve if a game can even make it to the store pages. Maybe the team playing it and approving the games just doesn't like one type of game. But it doesn't mean that the game won't find a following. And why should a developer who put their time and effort into a game not have a chance for it to be sold just because it didn't pass the approval process? Should we really have a gatekeeper for this type of thing? Or would it be better to leave it how we have it today, with letting anyone submit anything as long as they have their certification? I honestly do not know what the answer is to this. I think a good starting point could be to force all games to have a playable demo so that the consumers can get a glimpse of the game before they purchase it. This will add to the development time and create more work and possibly delay games for smaller studios, but I think a consumer has the right to try something before they buy it. Now, some other ideas I was thinking of were if a game has enough negative reviews and has been out for a certain amount of time and doesn't hit a certain threshold for sales, maybe they can remove it from the store. A game like Flat Out 3 has overwhelmingly negative reviews, and let's say it's sold under 5,000 units. Do we really need to keep it on the store? One part of me says give it the boot, there's no reason for it to be there. It's an older game, it did not do well, and it's not holding up. Why even bother having it? There's no reason to play it. But on the other hand, say someone really does want to play it. Now you just took a convenient way for them to purchase and play the game away. And shouldn't we be preserving all the games that we can? I don't really know what the right answer is for this one, or if there even is a right answer. And that's why I'm asking you guys. What do you think? Is this something you've thought about before? Do we need a game approval process, or is it just fine the way it is today? Please let me know in the comments down below. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Until the next one, see ya.